How's it going, everyone? Kellen Reck here, and today I've got a really easy tutorial on dynamic linking from Adobe Premiere to Adobe After Effects. Now, in my last video on the locked-on stabilization, a lot of people who were used to Premiere weren't sure totally how to get your edit from Premiere into After Effects, how you get it back, if you had to export the full sequence, if you had to build your edit in After Effects, and all of that. Well, let me tell you the trick, and this is one of the easiest ways that I do a lot of my After Effects effects, for lack of a better term. And basically, all you have to do is dynamic link. Now, this is a term that Adobe uses for basically connecting a Premiere project and an After Effects project. So we've got this full built-out sequence here, and you can see this one yellow clip. This is the clip, for example, that I want to use the effect on. And we'll just say, we're not gonna actually go through an effect in this, but say we were going to do the locked-on stabilization effect that I did in my last tutorial. Well, since you can't do that effect within Premiere, we need to bring it into After Effects. So what you do, you go to your clip, just the selection, just that one clip that you want to apply the effect to, and you right-click. You're going to go to Replace with After Effects Composition. Now your computer is going to open up After Effects, and it's going to bring just that clip into a composition within After Effects. Now, not only will it do this, but it'll create a linked nest in Premiere. Now you can see After Effects is opening here. It makes a new After Effects project for you. I usually just save it as the same name as my Premiere project. And you can see within After Effects, we have our clip within a composition. It's nested. You can see we actually have the full clip here, but it builds out the nest just for the selection of the clip that you use in your Premiere sequence. And if you go back into Premiere, you can see that our clip that was once yellow is now pink, and that means that it's a linked composition. So this is linked to After Effects. So if we go into After Effects and make any change, it'll do that back to Premiere. So let's just throw a curves effect on this clip and just give it a drastic kind of color change here. Just something crazy, we'll make it pink. If we go into Premiere, you'll see that that effect is applied. And you could do this with as many effects as you want. So if we go to, let's just go to a chunk of this clip here. We'll just take a small chunk. We don't need the full thing. Right click, replace with After Effects comp. We'll get an entirely new composition here. And I usually like to clean this up as I'm going, but you can see we've got linked comp one, linked comp two. And let's just apply another curves effect to this. We'll give it a weird sort of greenish look. And if we jump back into Premiere, you can see this clip is now green. And you can do anything you want. So everything that you do in After Effects will apply back to your clip. And now I've done this a lot for various titling effects. If we want to add a title to this here, hello, test. We'll make it white. We'll just have it sit right there. We jump back into Premiere. You've got your title there too, and you can do animations, and those will all carry over. So this is just a super quick tutorial I'm doing today. Just wanted you guys to see exactly how to do it. You can see these linked compositions come right into your Premiere project over here, and that's how I do it. So anytime that I'm doing work in After Effects based off of a sequence in Premiere, I'm doing the full non-linear edit within Premiere. I'm kicking it over to After Effects, saving that project, and then they come right back in as a linked comp within my Premiere project here. So that is how I do it. I hope it helps you out. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, leave a like, share the video if it helped you. Go ahead and subscribe, and we'll check you back in the next one. Thanks, guys.